Hi everyone, another day and another video from the Clevero studio. Today we're going to look beyond reality. The topic for today is augmented reality and the ways it can boost your business productivity. I'd like to start with the impressive AR forecast to demonstrate the relevance of this topic. Trusted sources like Woodside Capital say that by 2022, the most attractive markets for augmented reality expansion will be video gaming, healthcare, engineering, live events, retail, and real estate. According to Statista, profits are expected to exceed $162 billion and the number of users will reach 200 million. These facts are more than encouraging, so let's find out how exactly you can apply augmented reality in different business areas and consider the most successful examples. Naturally, we start with video gaming. Famous Niantic games like Pokemon Go and INGRESS prove the efficiency of AR technology. People are obsessed with the interaction of fictional characters in a real environment. Children's games also make a good use of it. For instance, Meet the Animals and QUIVER bring static pictures to life on device screens and impress kids with cool graphics. Medical apps using augmented reality serve not only doctors, but also people with non-medical professions. For example, AED4UA pinpoints the location of the nearest automated external defibrillators, and Amplified Robot Atlas demonstrates how to administer medicines and vaccines in the right way. Dedicated specialists may use healthcare apps for professional purposes. For instance, ACCUVEIN produces an app for the fast and accurate vein detection. MedSites Tech has developed a technology which allows surgeons to find the location and size of a tumour without using x-rays. AR is a real boon for engineers. Regardless of the type of machine you're working on, you can see how it's going to look from different sides and angles. eDrawings Standard and eDrawings Pro are good examples of using AR in CAD modeling and industrial engineering. Retail vendors are increasing sales thanks to the ability to show any product to their customers. Global giants like Coca-Cola and IKEA have developed exclusive apps to demonstrate their products, both in supermarkets and at home. Experts of style and beauty, Converse and L'Oreal, have revealed apps that allow you to try on shoes or put on makeup without actually having access to the product. In real estate, augmented reality serves architects, realtors, and consumers. The AR House app shows several alternatives of a future house and explains how they differ. It's hard to overestimate the role of AR with live events. Participants of trade shows and exhibitions don't need to produce large mock-ups to demonstrate their products. Holding a phone or tablet, they can show every detail of their projects. Well, we've looked through the main areas where AR is currently being used. And now I'd like to say a few words about the technical aspects of the subject and look into the development process of augmented reality. There are two ways to implement AR in an app. The first one is a marker-based approach. It uses a hard-coded object that is recognized by the app for building augmented reality. Usually such objects are represented by QR code since it has a particular structure, three distinctive squares and one smaller one. It helps to accurately define the size of the model and its position in space. The markerless approach is the second way to implement AR into an app. It is a more complex solution since your app needs to analyze the data and decide when and where the AR image should appear. It has no strict identifiers in the database. Instead, it knows what signs indicate its presence. If you decide to build an app with AR, there's no need to reinvent the wheel. Existing AR frameworks and libraries can help you. Some of them are really good, others not. In our opinion, tools such as Vuforia, Art Toolkit, Wikitude, LayAR, and Kudan AR offer the best solutions for building an AR application. You can find out more about them and AR in general by reading the full article on our site. To reach it, follow the link below. Well, that's all for today. We hope that today's information was useful. Stay healthy and follow us on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook. Bye for now.